started it.
No, sorry.
My dear friends, welcome to this beautiful little church of St. John's, where today Antonio and Leah are going to exchange marriage vows. The prayers that I say we'll make our own as we pray for their happiness together. Let us pray. Father, you've made the bond of marriage a holy mystery, a symbol of Christ's love for his church. Hear our prayers for Antonio and Leah. With faith in you and in each other, they pledge their love here today. May their lives always bear witness to the reality of that love. We ask you this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Could you all sit, please, as we hear the reading?
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. There are three things that last: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of all these is love. Be ambitious for the higher gifts, and I will show you a way that is better than any of them. If I have all the eloquence of men or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and even if I let them take my body to burn it, but I am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offence, and it is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Could you all stand, please, for this reading? Stand out of respect for the words spoken by Jesus himself. Jesus said, "From the beginning of creation, God made them male and female, and that's why a man must leave father and mother, and the two become one body. They're no longer two, therefore, but one body. So then what God has united, man must not divide." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Could you all have a seat for just a moment? My dear friends, that beautiful reading that we heard before this one talks about what real love is all about. Always patient, always kind, never resentful, doesn't take delight in other people's wrongdoings, but delights in the truth. It's always ready to excuse, to trust, and endure whatever comes. And finally, love does not come to an end. And that's the one thing, too, you should always remember in a marriage. There's always something there you can go back and build on. So here today, my dear friends, as we witness the exchange of love between Antonio and Leah, we pray that this love that has brought them together will endure, will grow stronger, and they can always build it and make it everlasting love. I'm losing my mask. Sorry about this. It's not that I was afraid of you, I was afraid of what I might give you. I woke up with a hacking cough this morning and I didn't want to share it, especially with these two. So here today, my dear friends, let's just be aware of the love that keeps our world together. And here today we pray for the future happiness of Antonio and Leah. I'd now ask the wedding party to assemble back here at the foot of God's altar. My dear friends, you've come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and this community. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He's already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Antonio and Leah, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
We have.
And will you love and honour each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
We will.
And will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
We will.
Since it's your intention to enter into marriage, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and his church. I, Antonio. Take you, Leah.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. I will love you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life. I, Leah.
Take you, Antonio.
To be my husband. I promise to be true to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. I will love you. And honor you. All the days of my life. You've declared your consent before the church. May the Lord, in his goodness, strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has joined, men must not divide. Amen. May the Lord bless these rings which you give to each other as the sign of your love and fidelity. Leah, take this ring.
As a sign
of my love.
Of my love.
And fidelity.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Antonio,
take this ring
as a sign of my love,
and fidelity.
In the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit. Father, by your power you've made everything out of nothing. In the beginning you created the universe and made mankind in your own likeness. You gave man the constant help of woman, so that man and woman should no longer be two, but one flesh. So that you teach us that what you've united may never be divided. Father, you've made the union of man and wife so holy a mystery that it symbolizes the marriage of Christ and his church. Father, by your plan, man and woman are united and married life has been established as the one blessing that was not forfeited by original sin or washed away in the flood. Look with love upon this woman, your daughter, now joined to her husband in marriage. She asks your blessing. Give her the grace of love and peace. May she always follow the example of the holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband put his trust in her and recognize that she is his equal and the heir with him to the life of grace. May he always honor her and love her as Christ loves his bride, the church. Father, keep them always true to your commandments. Keep them faithful in marriage and let them be living examples of Christian life. Give them the strength which comes from the gospel so that they may be witnesses of Christ to others. Bless them with children and help them to be good parents. May they live to see their children's children. And after a happy old age, grant them fullness of life with the saints in the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Could you stay seated, please, as we have the prayers of the faithful. My dear friends, let's ask God to bless Leah and Antonio throughout their married life and to hear these intentions for which we now pray.
For Leah and Antonio, may their love be patient and kind, ready to trust and to endure whatever happens. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the parents, friends and relatives of Leah and Antonio, that the example of love and hospitality given by Leah and Antonio in their married love may touch them and those in need in our community. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For married couples, that they may grow in mutual love and reflect that love in their family life and service of others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For members of the church, that they may show the meaning of Christ's love by their love for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the deceased relatives and friends of Leah and Antonio, that they may experience the joys of eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving Father, we ask you to hear these prayers for Leah and Antonio. Make them happy in their married life and may they grow in the years ahead. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Could you stay there now, please, while we sign the registers? Thank you.
may their love be patient and gentle, ready to trust and endure whatever comes. Amen. May they pray together in joy and sorrow, and always give thanks for the gift of each other.
Amen.
May your peace dwell in their home and give hope and peace to the world.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down on you both and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Cummins Beatrio.
Big cheers. 3, 2, 1, arms up, cheers. That looks awesome. All right, we're going to do that one more time.
So we'll welcome the maid of honour and the best man, Madeline Mataji and Emmanuel Kompatakis.
Please don't smash glasses and plates. The only thing you want smashed is the food, the drink, and some leaves. Please help us consume all the food. There is approximately 250 grams of onion for everyone. As for the drinks, whilst there's a starting amount on everyone's tables, there will be staff helping to replenish. Sorry, I've moved my lips away from it. However, please feel free to go up to the bar if you need to replenish bottles of beer, wine, champagne, and soft drinks and juice if you're a child. Right. But please, we want to see very little waste this evening. So, however, please stay capable of using your legs for the dance floor and your brain for how you get home. Yeah. Please feel free to take video and photos as the photographers and videographer will be finishing earlier than the night will go on. So Leon and I would like to spend the next 45 minutes or so going around each of the tables to take official photos with everybody. So nothing's going to miss out. If you're out for the evening, you hear a magic song. This is important. In the background that you like, please feel free to grab a partner and have a slow dance. Even if it's before our official first dance. for the time being, certainly laugh, talk, mix, and stay tuned for the events to unfold. Buon appetito! Please, Lorenzo, have your action.
Before I offer this, it's actually a tradition where if you get to tap your fork or spoon, whatever, on the glass, that means you'll have a conversation with a kiss. So get that in mind.
Till death do us.